three champs. So I think Astralis' comp is super well-rounded, and that's a victor for the side of SK. So SK has opted for this teamfight comp as well. They've gone for the mage. We're seeing two huge teamfight comps. Yeah, and I just love the efficiency from Xandar. If you just look at the map in general, you can see he's going to take the Drake. His bot camps are just about respawning. You can do Drake, clear his bot camps to the top side, and then start playing with the Renekton and Six to play for the Herald.
And important note, Xandar also no real ultimate here. So have to be careful, have to respect the Hecarim to a certain degree. That said, White Knight right now, very strong. Level 7 Renekton compared to the rest of the competition, not one to be underestimated. Xandar is going to throw another hook. The flash, the hook on Treats hits the perfect target. The sidestep is not what the team needed. Immediate first blood, though. Now just burning through the team. A double kill. Not really going to be able to clear this wave out as quickly as he'd like.
They have TP as well.
This could be massive. Promise Q on the flank. They have spotted him out. They have to be careful. Jezu caught out, knocked back under tower. He cannot afford to stand there, but there is the lantern right in time. Treats not going to connect the hook on this time. Will throw down the ultimate, but there's White Knight on the backside. The immediate stun follow up. Where's it going to be? Blue now in trouble. Boom. Haymaker not going to connect. Blue running as for his life. His Tinks goes for the body block. Every
game for SK.
Astralis now going to find their second Drake of the game as we take a look back at this fight. And if you're wondering why you pick Thresh with Aphelios, by the way, this is why.
This is why you pick Thresh with Aphelios. This is why Aphelios can't be played. Well, it can be, but not really with other supports. So he gets flipped, flash flipped. Flash takes the lantern just in time, dodges Xandar's combo, and White Knight behind. He does get in the fight, but his Q was empowered. You can see he doesn't have rage now, so the W is not as long as he would want it to be. The stun wasn't enough. Xandar flashes forward. And if the stun was a tiny bit longer and Xandar played, if White Knight played better around his rage, he could have got two there perhaps, but. And the key thing to look at now is the fact that Astralis has two dragons and it's an ocean soul, which is game-changing as Blue has no flash.
I thought, moving forward, Blue. Is he just going to get shredded down? That's just too much damage.
Difficult thing to do, and certainly
Gen-X.
Much better than the other way around. Is Gen-X going to try to body slam through, but Renekton going to body block him there. Spear now going to land, but Tinks on the way in. White Knight immediately backing out there. Big ulti now coming in. They're going to try to take out the Renekton, but I don't know if that's a target that you can actually shut down at this point. Treats, though. Bringing it back up is Jezu also coming into the fight, and Xandar just continuing to throw spears over the wall. They will slowly, but surely, take White
from Gen-X and the Gragas, so made sure he picked them up. They're going to lose bot tower for that rotation to mid, though, but they will answer with the mid tower. So overall, a net good play there from the side of SK. White Knight loses his life.
In order to keep some pressure here around the dragon, they very much have to be careful. Treats, there is no Thresh to lantern you out, buddy, but the hook hits and it might not matter. Xandar goes golden, but he should still get stunned up here. Is forced to flash out to safety. Excellent Aphelios ult now coming in, and that's going to be one big Hecarim ult. That is one fleeing Kai'Sa now. Jessica tries to run for the hills. A little bit of extra damage. Is forced to flash out to safety. Barrel knocks Promise Q right back into the wall. Set should be done, but they're not going to follow up. Setting their eyes on the prize. They know the Drake is what they need to play for as White Knight dashes over the wall. Gen-X still very tanky. The Liandry's from Nuke Duck. Not quite enough damage to burn him down yet.
Yeah, Xandar getting caught out there. You could see them poking and prodding for the vision. Treats does hit another key hook for the objective, so they're going to start up this dragon. I think Astralis want to fight this 4v5. White Knight has ult. He has flash. He gets hooked, though.
Oh, already has been locked up. Now trying to double dash with the team. Of course, has the Gore Drinker as well, so will be difficult to knock down. But the body slam stops him from coming back over the wall with the blast cone. SK with priority access here. Xandar not in the area. Should mean that they can take this one down. They do get it. Going over to Jezu.
Earlier, around 30 seconds ago, get topside vision. Now they're using that to make sure they get the tier 1 top. And Astralis is going to get the mid wave, so what can they trade it for? I think if they step up for the tower, it's a bit risky. Promise Q's in a position where he's looking for a dive, but I think Gen-X is a bit too tanky, but they might go for it anyway.
Very risky, because it's going to take a long time to kill Gen-X. Yep. Gen-X, not really any tools, though, to just delete
might
this
look
wave.
For any H.
White Knight potentially has overstayed his welcome. Jezu going to step forward. Onslaught getting proc just to get as many shurikens as possible. Swap through for the Chakram. Has the Gale Force with the Cloud Burst as well, but is going to find the stun under the tower. Tinks pulled out.
Even White Knight's just rotating down. I think he should have been hitting top tower and uses TP, but another hook from Treats.
Again? Are you kidding me, Treats? Jungler has been caught out, but there is no follow-up. This time around, Treats potentially overstaying his welcome. Gravity Field goes down and buys Gen-X the space he needs to continue to threaten on the front line, but he has to be careful. Xandar stunned up. Almost no damage onto Gen-X. That is one tanky boy with the flashback. Set throwing Gen-X into the backline. Gen-X now trying to move through the entire team. That's the Hecarim barreling on through. But Gen-X now on a killing spree. White Knight has to run for the hills. And Astralis are not strong enough to stand toe-to-toe with SK.
Yeah, White Knight and Promise Q get taken down. They're going to go for the dragon here. You saw Promise Q just flash in there. He was tired of Gen-X being in their face. They're going to pull the dragon out to make sure that Xandar can't see it. But I think he's going to look for it. Does decide to back off. I don't think he has any vision because of the pink ward. And that's a one team fight for SK.
SK contributing to the vision game here this time around, giving them a lot of control over the Baron area. Xandar is fishing with spears. We're going to go in. Nuke Duck has been isolated. It's going to get caught out here. Where's the follow-up going to go, though? Gen-X trying to find it. He's managed to knock Xandar back to the team one more time. That's going to be Shockwave. Maybe the turn. White Knight trying to find his way into the backline, trying to get this damage down. Treat trying to buy as much space for Jezu as possible. That is a lot of shurikens for the Aphelios if he can keep this fight going. But no, too much damage. It's going to stop the follow-up. Jeskler! And that is why you pick the Kai'Sa.
Get it, but they're turning away. Wait, look at White Knight's TP. He's TPing behind them.
Blue isolated for now, can immediately throw down all of his skills before he goes down. He's going to flash out to safety, though. Don't know if that was necessary. And that's going to be three Drakes picked up. This is disaster for Astralis. They made a call, but they did not follow through. Triple Ocean Drake looking at potentially quad Ocean Soul.
Going to be available, Kai'Sa ult as well. That's going to be the hook onto White Knight to pull back off the objective. Their focus is on the kill instead, and that's going to be White Knight diving into the middle. The team's Gore Drinker has been procced alongside the Sterics, but Nuke Duck now the one in trouble. White Knight on the retreat. Xandar in the midst of everybody, but you are a Nidalee. You have no business being there.
Astralis now have to run for the hills before SK can get anything else. Blue continuing to chase down here, but SK, nothing really left for them. A bit of a cheeky cloud burst into the Ophelios ultimate there, and it looks like they will be able to catch out Jethro, but that's now the dunk down for Promise Q, but he's just buying space for the rest of his team. And Cadrel.
Yeah, wait, they can't re-engage, they can't turn with any damage. The Kai'Sa has to run away, the Orianna has to run away. And if you're in that position, it's really hard to win fights. So SK, clean play around vision. I think Treats with him as well. We have Baron. If it's a base race, we're going to win. Now they're trying to face check again.
Treats again, finding the hook. White Knight a good frontliner for now. Genix trying to buy a bit more space, but no, Nuke Duck has been caught out. Big damage now coming through. Genix unkillable. Ophelios unstoppable in the backside here as Jeskla is just looking for the opportunity, but he can't. He does not have the damage, he does not have the space to work to find these kills. And that might just be it, Cadrel.
Yeah, this is the problem that Astralis has been facing the whole game long. They're either getting chased down or they have to face check. And this has been happening every fight. They could never set up a fight where they were the ones engaging, they were the ones running them down, or they were the ones catching them over vision, because after that Herald fight in the early game, it just fell apart for them.
And brutal to watch as SK, very effortlessly it feels like in these games. Obviously great map calls across, never putting themselves in a position where they can really lose. But now that they've built this advantage, they are going to bring it home. Astralis and SK, two relatively brand new rosters setting foot on the stage here, but it is the rookies of SK who will find the win today. The veteranship of the Astralis lineup, not enough to find a win.
Yeah, and I just think SK's comp overall was just solid overall. You know, you have so much teamfight prowess, so much zone control. There's really not much that SK, that the